Hello students, today we are going to start chapter 3 of class 10 mathematics, and the chapter is pair of linear equations in two variables. In class 9 already we have studied linear equation in two variables, but now we are going to study pair of linear equations in two variables. I think all of you know what is meant by pair. Pair means two. So this time we will be seeing two linear equations at a time. And as you all know, the standard form of a linear equation two variable is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This was already taught in class 9. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is the standard form of a linear equation in two variables, where a, b, c are the constants, x and y are the variables. But this year we have pair of linear equations. So there will be two linear equations at a time. So the standard form of pair of linear equation in two variables is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. This is equation number 1. a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This is equation number 2. I repeat, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0 are the standard form of pair of linear equation in two variables, where a1 b1 c1, a2 b2 c2 are the constants, and these constant can have any value, any real value. So x and y are the variables. Now coming to life related questions, what is the actual use of algebra in our daily life? We will be discussing so many questions which can be converted into linear equation, and then we will study how to solve it. So before coming to the first exercise, let me tell you something more about pair of linear equation. In class 9 we have studied, for a single linear equation two variable, there exist infinitely many solutions. Infinite values of x and infinite value of y. But for a pair of linear equation, or it is also called system of linear equation, for a pair of linear equations there can be three types of solutions, and the first one is unique solution. That means only one solution, one value of x and one value of y. And the second one is infinitely many solutions. And the third one is no solution. I repeat, a pair of linear equation two variable can have three types of solutions. First one, unique solution, that means only one value of x and one value of y. Second one is infinitely many solution, infinite value of x and infinite value of y. And the third one is no solution. This equation cannot be solved. Now, without actually solving a pair of linear equation, we can check whether the given pair of linear equation has unique solution, infinitely many solution, or no solution. Please listen. For unique solution, the condition is, if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. What is a1 upon a2? This is a1 and this is a2. We will take a1 upon a2, that that is coefficient of x of the first equation upon coefficient of x of the second equation. This ratio should not be equal to b1 upon b2, that is y coefficients of equation 1 and equation 2. So if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, this system of equation will have unique solution, one value of x and one value of y. Coming to second, infinitely many solution. The condition is if a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is again equal to c1 upon c2, then this system of equation will have infinitely many solution. All the three ratios are equal. A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2 are equal, then the system will have infinitely many solutions. Coming to the third one, no solution, the condition is if A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 but not equal to C1 upon C2. I repeat, if A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 but not equal to C1 upon C2, then the system will have no solution. I repeat, if A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2, unique solution. If A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 equal to C1 upon C2, then infinitely many solution. If A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 but not equal to C1 upon C2, then it has no solution. One more point. If a system of linear equation has either unique solution or infinitely many solution, in both the case, the system is said to be consistent. If a pair of linear equation has either unique solution or infinitely many solution, in both the case the system is said to be consistent. Consistent. If the system has no solution, then the system is said to be inconsistent. So consistent means having unique solution or infinitely many solution. Inconsistent means having no solution. So, this is the condition using which we can check whether the given pair of linear equation has unique solution, infinitely many solution, no solution, consistent or inconsistent. Now, we are going to discuss the various methods by which we can solve a pair of linear equation. There are many methods to solve a pair of linear equation, and the first method is graphical method with the help of graph. In class 9 you have studied how to draw the graph of a single linear equation in two variables. Same thing is repeated. This time the same method is to be applied for two equations. For one single linear equation, we had graphical representation in class 9, and all of you must be remembering, the shape of a linear equation in two variables, graph is always a straight line. So for a single linear equation, you will get a straight line. For two linear equations, you will get two straight lines. So this time, we will be drawing both these straight lines on the same graph paper. Now, when two straight lines are drawn on the same graph paper, it can occur in three different ways. Number one, both the graphs can intersect each other. Both the straight lines can intersect each other at some point. Second, both the graphs can coincide with one another. First line and the second line will come over the first line itself. So it is called coinciding lines. And the third possibility is both the lines can be parallel to each other. So the graph of a pair of linear equations can be either intersecting lines or coinciding lines or parallel lines. Accordingly, the type of solution will also change. If the graph represents intersecting lines, then that system of equation will have unique solution. I repeat, if the graph of a pair of linear equations represent intersecting lines, then that pair of linear equations will have unique solution. That means one particular value of x and one particular value of y. And what is that unique solution? The unique solution in that case will be the point of intersection of both the graphs. The point of intersection will have an x coordinate and a y coordinate. X coordinate of the point of intersection is the value of x. Y coordinate of the point of intersection is the value of y. We will come to it later. Second possibility is it can have coincident lines. Coincident lines means one graph over the other graph. It means all the points of both the graphs are common. Actually, the common point of both the graphs is the solution of linear equation. For two coinciding lines, all the points are common. So, all the points are the solution. So, we can say, if the graph represents coincident lines, then the system of equation will have infinitely many solutions. Third, if the two graphs are parallel lines, then that system of linear equation has no solution, because for two parallel lines, no point is common between them. Since there is no point is common between two parallel lines, the system has no solution. So I repeat once again. If the two graphs represented by the pair of linear equations is intersecting lines, then that system has unique solution. One value of x and one value of y. If the graph represents coincident lines, then the system has infinitely many solutions. If the graph represents parallel lines, then the system has no solution. When we compare it with the previous one, we can say, if the graph represents intersecting line, then its a1 upon a2 value will not be equal to b1 upon b2. And combining both, if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, it has unique solution. And unique solution means the graph will be intersecting line. Vice versa, if the graph represents intersecting lines, then it will have unique solution. And in that case, a1 upon a2 will not be equal to b1 upon b2. Similarly, if the graph represents coincident lines, it has infinitely many solution. The condition will be a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. Finally, if the graph represents parallel lines, it will have no solution. In that case, a1 upon a2 will be equal to b1 upon b2 but will not be equal to c1 upon c2. So this is the combination of graphical representation, type of solution, and this is the coefficient relation. Now we are going to study the first method of solving a pair of linear equations, that is by using graphical method. Okay, all of you take exercise 3.1 of NCERT. Exercise 3.1, that is the first exercise. Question number 1. Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago, I was 7 times as old as you were then. Also, 3 years from now, I shall be 3 times as old as you. As old as you will be. Represent the situation algebraically and graphically. I repeat the question. This question is all about the age of two people. Who are they? Aftab and his daughter. So, when you read the whole question, you can see that two things are mentioned in this question. Aftab's age and his daughter's age. So the first and foremost thing for considering, while considering a pair of linear equations, the two unknowns mentioned in the questions will be taken as x and y. And as you all know, whenever we solve the questions of age, always let the present age be x and y. So here we can take, let the present age of Aftab is equal to x years. Let the present age of his daughter is equal to y years. Now see the first condition. The first condition states that 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were then. So if the present age of Aftab is x, 7 years ago it will be x minus 7. Age of daughter 7 years ago will be y minus 7. So according to first condition, we can make the first equation. What is that? 7 years ago, Aftab age was 7 times. 7 times means into 7. So Aftab 7 years ago was x minus 7. Now he says, 7 years ago my age was 7 times the age of my daughter. So daughter was y minus 7. Now 7 times means into 7. So the, according to first condition, the first equation is x minus 7 is equal to 7 into y minus 7. Open the bracket. That is x minus 7 is equal to 7y minus 49. Now make it into standard form. X minus 7y minus 7 plus 49 equal to 0. That is x minus 7y plus 42 equal to 0. This is equation number 1. Now, see the second condition. Now, the second condition states that 3 years from now, that means plus 3. Aftab tells, after 3 years, my age will be 3 times as old as my daughter's. So, present age of Aftab is x. So, after 3 years, it will become x plus 3. Then, daughter will become y plus 3. So, according to second condition, x plus 3 will be equal to 3 times y plus 3. Open the bracket. X plus 3 is equal to 3y plus 9, or x minus 3y plus 3 minus 9 equal to 0. X minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. This is equation number 2. I repeat, according to first condition, we got the first equation, x minus 7y plus 42 equal to 0. According to second condition, we got the second equation, that is x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. This is called algebraic representation. So there are two parts of the question, represented algebraically and graphically. Algebraically we have represented it. This is called algebraical representation of this question. First equation represents the first condition, second equation represents second condition. So the first part of the answer is over. Now second part, represent it graphically. I told you, we can draw the graph of every linear equation two variables. So this linear equation will give us one graph, which will be a straight line. This will also be another straight line. So now we are going to draw the graph of both these equations. Once again, I am writing this equation. The first equation is x minus 7y plus 42 equal to 0. You know how to draw the graph of a linear equation two variable, that was taught in class 9. This year, I may tell you, for your easiness, we can rewrite this equation either for x equal to or y equal to, so that the calculation will become a little easy for you. The method is that we will give any one value, any imaginary value for one of the variable. While putting that value in place of x or y, we will get the value of the other variable. So as I see this equation, I see x is a norm. So better we convert this equation for x, then it will become x is equal to 7y minus 42. This is easy for us to calculate the values. Now we need set of solution of this equation. I may suggest always find out four set of solutions for drawing the graph of a linear equation. Four x value and four y value. And while drawing the table, you must always take care x must be put above and y must come below. Now, since I have rewritten this equation for x is equal to, let us now put the value of y. While putting the value of y, we will get the corresponding value of x. Now, by seeing the nature of this equation, and in order to get positive values, let us give the value y is equal to 6. Putting y is equal to 6, x is equal to 7 into 6, 42, 42 minus 42, 0. Now let us put y is equal to 7, 7 into 7, 49, 49 minus 42, 7. Now put 8, 7 into 8, 56, 56, 56 minus 42, 14. Putting 9, 9 into 7, 63 minus 42, 21. So we got four set of values for the first equation. 0, 6, 7, 7, 14, 8, 21, 9. Now let us consider the second equation. Second equation is x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. As above, I am going to rewrite this equation for x is equal to. So it will become x is equal to 3y plus 6. Once again, we have to find 4 set of solutions. X, Y, let us find 4 set of solutions. Now what can be the possible values of y? Putting y is equal to 0, we get x equal to 6. Putting y is equal to 1, we will get 3 into 1, 3, 3 plus 6, 9. Putting y is equal to 2, 3 into 2, 6, 6 plus 6, 12. Putting y is equal to 3, it will become 3 into 3, 9, 9 plus 6, 15. So, both the tables are ready now for drawing the graph. Now, while drawing the x-axis and y-axis, you must have a thorough look into both the tables, because we have to draw the graph of both the equations on the same graph paper. So, while selecting the scale for x-axis and y-axis, you must have both the tables in your mind. Accordingly, we have to take the scale of x-axis and y-axis. For example, here we have, for the first equation we have x values from 0 to 21. For the second equation we have x values from 6 to 50. So minimum value 0, maximum value 21. Y value, here we have 6, 7, 8, 9. Maximum 9, minimum 6. Here we have 0 to 3. So y, on y axis we require 0 to 9. So for y axis we can have the scale 1 unit equal to 1. But for x axis, if you have 21 units on x axis, then no problem. Take 1 unit equal to 1. If not, depending upon your graph paper, you can take 1 unit is equal to 2 also. And one more thing. Since both the table have the values both positive, all the points of both the equation will lie in the first quadrant. So we can draw the graph paper, x-axis and y-axis, in such a way that we get maximum space in first quadrant. So draw x-axis at extreme down. And draw y-axis to your extreme left. So this is y-axis and this is x-axis. So that the maximum space of the graph paper can be utilized for plotting these two tables. Now on x-axis, since 0 to 21. If you have sufficient space, then you take 1 unit equal to 1. Or you can go 1 unit equal to, 1 unit equal to 2 if you have the space. Anyway, I am going to take 1 unit is equal to 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. On y-axis we require minimum 0, maximum 9. So you can take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now we are going to plot the points of first table. The first point is 0, 6. X-axis 0, y-axis 6. This is the point 0, 6. Second is 7, 7. 7, comma 7. Almost this is the point, 7 comma 7. Now 14 comma 8. 14, 8. Then 21 comma 9. 21 and from there 9. Now join all these points with the help of your scale. Since I don't have a scale, my line may not be straight even this. So this is the graph of the first equation. Now, whenever you draw the graph, you must write that equation over the line. So this is the graph of x minus 7y plus 42 equal to 0. Now coming to the next graph, first point is 6 comma 0. 6 comma 0, this is 6 comma 0. 9 comma 1, 9 comma 1. 12 comma 2, 12 comma 2. 15 comma 3, 15 comma 3. Now join all these points. You will get another straight line. Once again, write the equation over the line. This is x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. Now, if you look at the shape of both the graph, you can see that they are not intersecting in our vicinity. But if you see the shape, you can see that on producing, they will meet at a point. So this equations represent intersecting lines. Anyway, that is not asked in the question. Only the question is represent it algebraically. This is the algebraic representation. Second part, represent it graphically. This is the graphical representation. Now finding the solution will be the next chapter, next exercise. So for this question, you have to draw both the graph on the same graph paper, make both the equation, algebraic representation is over, draw the graph, graphical representation is also over. Now let's see the second question, read the second question.
The coach of a cricket team buys 3 bats at 6 balls for 3,500 rupees.
Okay, the coach of a cricket team buys... how many bats?
3 bats.
3 bats.
At 6 balls.
And 6 balls. Now, second condition.
Later, she buys another bat at 3 balls for the same kind of rupees, 1,300.
Okay. Later, the coach buys 1 bat and 3 balls for rupees?
1,300.
So, this question is all about cost of a cricket bat and cost of a ball. So as I told you earlier, we will let the cost of one bat is equal to x rupees and one ball is equal to y rupees. So question number 2, let the cost of one bat is equal to x rupees, let the cost of one ball is equal to y rupees. According to first condition, the cost of
3 bats at 6 balls
3 bats plus 6 ball is equal to
3900.
So the cost of 3 bat is 3x and the cost of
6
ball is equal to 6y is equal to 3900. So this is equation number 1. This is the algebraic representation. So the first part is over. 3x plus 6y equal to 3900 is equation number 1. Now according to second condition, she buys one more bat. Is it?
Yes.
So one bat means x and
3 balls.
3 balls means 3y. The cost is 1300. This is equation number 2. So algebraic representation is over. The first equation is 3x plus 6y equal to 3900. Second equation is x plus 3y equal to 1300. So first part of the question is over. Algebraic representation is over. Now second part is graphical representation. So once again we have to draw the graph of this equation and we have to draw the graph of second equation. Let's see. Once again I am writing down the equation. 3x plus 6y equal to 3900. You see 3, 6 and 3900. 3 is common in both the sides. If anything is common on both the sides of an equation, we can take that common outside and cancel it, so that the equation will become little simpler form. So taking 3 common and cancelling from both sides, this equation can be rewritten as x plus 2y is equal to 1300. Clear? 3, 6, 3900 will become, taking 3 common and cancelling from both sides, x plus 2y is equal to 1300. Equation number 1. Now draw the table for it. Again, four set of solution. Yes, we can rewrite this equation as x is equal to 1300 minus 2y. X is equal to 1300 minus 2y. This is a quite big number, 1300. So while taking the values of y, you have to be a little more careful so that both the values may match up. So don't take 0, 1, 2, 3 this time. Here is some bigger values. Say for example, let us take y is equal to 100. While taking y is equal to 100, it becomes 2 into 100, 200, 1300 minus 200, 1100. Now let us take y is equal to 200. 2 into 2, 400, 1300 minus 400, 900. Now take 300. 600, 1300 minus 600,
800.
1300 minus 600, 700. Now taking y is equal to 400, it is 2 into 4, 800. 1300 minus 800,
500.
Okay, the table is ready. Now let us take the second equation, that is x plus 3y is equal to 1300. We can rewrite it as x is equal to 1300 minus 3y. Table. Once again, take the same values, putting y is equal to 100. 1300 minus 300, 1000. Take y is equal to 200. 1300 minus 600,
700.
Taking y is equal to 300, 3 into 300, 900. 1300 minus 900,
400.
Then taking y is equal to 400, we get
100.
1300 minus 1200 equal to 100. This time also, we have to take the scale on x axis and y axis according to both the tables. Here we have x values maximum 1100 and minimum 100. 100 to 1100 is needed on x axis and y axis 100 to 400. So let us take 1 unit is equal to 100 for both x axis and y axis. Once again, you can see both the table values are plus, comma, plus. That means all the points will be lying in the first quadrant. So once again, draw x axis at extreme down, draw y axis to your extreme left. On x axis we can take 1 unit is equal to 100. So 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000, 1100. Now on y axis, once again we can take 1 unit is equal to 100. So 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, and 900. Now we are going to plot the points of the first equation. The first point is 1100, 100. 1100 on x axis, 100 on y axis. 1100, 100. This is the point 1100, 100. Second point is 900, 200. 900, 200. And the third one is 700, 300. 700, 300. 500, 400. 500, 400. So the points are plotted. Now join them. Always extend the first point and the last point little more towards both the side and put arrow marks on both the side, because the graph is a line, not line segment. And write the equation above it. 3x plus 6y equal to 3900. 3x plus 6y equal to 3900. Now let us plot the second graph. Points are 1000, 100. 1000, 100. This is the point 1000, 100. 700, 200. 700, 200. Hundred, 400. 400. Then joined. You got the second line and write the equation above it. X plus 3y is equal to 1300. So algebraic representation, equation number 1 and equation number 2. These are the algebraic representation and this is the graphical representation. So second question is also over. Both algebraic expression, representation and graphical representation is over. Read the third question.
The cost of 2 kg of apples and 1 kg of grapes for a day was found to be ₹160.
See, question number 3 is the cost of the cost of 2 kg of apples and 1 kg of grapes on a day was found to be ₹160. So this question is all about cost of apples and cost of grapes. So as I told you earlier, let the cost of 1 kg of apple is equal to X rupees. Let the cost of 1 kg grapes is equal to Y rupees. So according to first condition, 2 kg apple plus 1 kg grape is equal to 160. So 2 kg apple 2x, 1 kg grapes 1y is equal to 160. Equation number 1. Second condition, after a month the cost of 4 kg apple, 4 kg apple means 4x plus 2 kg grapes, 2 kg grapes 2y is equal to 300. Over. So algebraic expression is over. So you have to start like this. Let the cost of 1 kg apple is equal to X rupees. Let the cost of 1 kg grape is equal to Y rupees. According to first condition, 2x plus y is equal to 160. Equation number 1. According to second condition, 4x plus 2y is equal to 300. Equation number 2. Now all of you do it as a homework. Algebraic expression is over. Now take the tables for first equation and second equation as we have discussed earlier and plot both the graphs on the same graph paper and see what shape of graph you obtain. That is the graphical representation. Here also you can cut short second equation. 4, 2, 300. 2 can be taken common and can balance, cancel from both sides. So it will become 2x plus y is equal to 150. So please do it as homework. That is the first exercise. So I will continue with the next exercise in the next video. Till then, please practice all these questions. And if you have any inquiry, you can ask. Give your feedback. Then I will explain once again. So thank you. Please do exercise 1. Thank you.